Welcome back, everyone, to Knights of the Old Republic 2 of the Sith Lords. And hello from chat, Tyron. Speaking of Tyron, I've done a little bit of save editing again since last episode, if you look in my inventory. Atten has a regular-ass lightsaber. So does Visus, and I've actually given lightsabers to Beida. I have a disciple. That is all. Who's ready to launch into the best part, the best gameplay sequence of the entire game? Raise his hand. Who's ready for the Onderonian Civil War? Raise his hand. Also, I've re-equipped the Fawn robe that I grabbed at the end of the last stream and upgraded it. Tomb! 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 Let's just travel. Here we are. Just take Candorous. In fact, no. Really quickly. I'm just gonna go ahead and level up everyone I'm not taking. I know it doesn't matter who I'm taking here, that's why I'm just gonna level up everyone I'm not taking in on the adventure. No, Candorous. I'm taking you on the adventure.
I am listening. I am ready.
I'm just going to give you enlightenment powers, even though you can't take enlightenment. Is that cool? That's what auto level up is for, Tyron. See? All I have to do is press one magic button. I will use Disciple one more time, but it's not going to be for combat purposes. It's going to be scenic purposes only. HK is not coming on the adventure. Neither is T3. In fact, I think I'm safe leaving HK's level up until we go to the factory, so T3 and Visus. probably could use some toughness. I know, Taryn, but I just want to level up TV. It's like a warm, fuzzy feeling. Improved energy resistance, I guess. Aside from potentially Atten, I'm bringing everyone else. I'm torn between bringing Atten or the Handmaiden for the section. On your own.
Reporting is ordered, Mandalore. I can take you wherever you need to go on Tuxen.
It's up to you, Jedi. This soldier knows the terrain. He can get us where we need to go quickly, without needing to blast our way through herds of Canucks.
What Canucks? We killed them all. Anyway, let's go to the camp.
Follow me, then.
You received my message, then. A man named Kavar wanted to get a hold of you urgently. He said that the Queen had arranged safe passage to Onderon for you, but I don't know how good their offer is anymore.
What's changed?
This morning, General Vaklu met with the Council of Lords and declared that the Queen was guilty of treason. He'll be made regent if Talia and her royal guard are defeated. The military is divided on who to support. Civil war has fallen on Isis.
How can we help out the Queen? She seems to be overwhelmed.
I doubt that Queen Talia and her advisor will survive until nightfall. The balance of forces seem to favor Queen Talia. The royal palace is heavily fortified and defensible, and most of the soldiers are loyal to her. But Vaklu has new allies, Sith soldiers and their masters. The war has also driven the caged beasts in the streets mad. Braylor and I both concur. She doesn't stand a chance.
You underestimate the force, Mandalorian. I sense that we may still get to Master Kavar in time. I sense there is something stirring on the moon itself. Tell me, have your senses picked up anything from Duxon?
Yes, we have. How? We picked up some transmissions from nearby in the jungle. Zuka's satellite relay has also picked up several shuttle launches with old Sith transmitter IDs. Some sort of staging base, perhaps.
The Sith forces must be stopped. Otherwise, the Mandalorian is right. Master Kavar and Queen Talia won't survive this day.
Dividing our forces at a time like this is foolhardy.
And this is why a common soldier will never triumph against a Jedi. Your military tactics are nothing compared to the Force.
It is essential and inevitable that we face both enemies at the same time.
I will have to lead the forces on heading towards the Royal Palace, won't I?
You are correct. You must choose who will lead the expedition through the jungle to find our enemies and defeat them.
I mean, there are plenty of good options, but there is one option here. I'm sorry. I'm going to save this before I choose my leader, which is going to be Baedur in this case. But I'm sorry. I know what they're trying to go for here, but in terms of how the characters work, how each of your companions work, the obvious choice, and I mean the obvious choice, to lead the second party towards the tomb should be Kandros. He's the only one of the rest of the party who has had leadership experience. And leadership experience is vital. Either way, I'm going to send Baedur as the leader. Yes, we have to pick a Jedi because it's a Star Wars game. Anyway, Baedur.
Alright.
You should send two others to go with the leader. Who else will accompany the expedition?
Mira.
Okay. And who else?
Mandalore.
Excellent choice. Now, are you certain of your choices?
Yes, I'm certain, because this is the party I always send to Duxon.
Mandalorian warriors will go with you to find the enemy camp. Just let me know when you want to head out. If you need supplies, talk with Kex. After you get into the jungle, you might not have another opportunity to stock up. Let me know if you want to go now.
I'm ready.
As you wish. Mandalore has arranged for special transportation to get to Isis.
Finally, we're close to our objective. I sent the rest of my men to secure the trail behind us. My troops will keep the path to the Mandalorian camp clear. Ahead lies the enemy. I can follow you a little bit further, but then I will set up command and control for my unit in the field. So lead on.
Yeah, I know. I know what you mean, Tyrone. I was just being a little bit sarky. Vader is always the toughest person to choose powers for. He really is. I know. Get that defense up for you, boy. I know Beta is the leader, but I personally like playing as Mira. I really do. I do like Mira's combat style.
Who wants to die first?
Take him down. This one. This one.
Red lab. That's another one for you.
Nice.
Type 2 perimeter motion relay. That particular model has several security vulnerabilities and design flaws. Stealth field generators can fool them. If one of us could get close to it, I know the corporate override code for it. Amateurs shouldn't even bother building security technology.
So, you aren't completely ignorant in the ways of battle? Good. But all of you must pass through its perimeter, and undetected would be better.
I think Mira's skilled in stealth. We'll send up others up ahead. They'll use my code to bypass the sensors.
Avoid the mines. If any of the ones close to the sensor are detonated, then we shouldn't even bother.
Let me check Mira's skills. No. No. Canterous has stealth! Candorous is the best suitor to stealth out of anyone. I'm gonna make a save here. I kinda wanna see how this works. I wanna see Candorous try using stealth.
Let me scout the area.
Half, man, inch forward like that. There's a little bit of a gap. Inch forward. Oh my god, it works. It works! It doesn't matter, Tyron. It worked with Candorous. I got it to work with Candorous. That is a miracle. Use Bader's corporate override code.
Let's move out.
I'm gonna keep Candorous and stealth over there so he doesn't run into any of the mines. And keep Beta back there so he doesn't run into the mines. I'll get Mira to walk forward and disable them all. Collect them all, as it were. I can't believe that worked. It would have still detected me without the solar, even in solar mode. Anyway. I'm going to put Candorous' actual belt back on.
Take them down.
That's the turret's taken care of.
Intruders, kill them!
Very inspiring.
No, I'll take care of it.
I know, Tyrant. Grade A writing. Grade A writing. Amazing writing, ladies and gentlemen. That guy needs a writing award. There's your BAFTA, enjoy it. I hope you enjoy your BAFTA, pal. That was amazing acting. Not everyone can get into a battle, act like they're in a battle situation and act like they've got severe constipation. That is amazing. Excellent work. Yep, that's the best Darkseid blaster in the game. At least I'm pretty sure Freedom Dance Blaster is the best Darkseid gun. Well, the best Darkseid guns in the game. Foothold scenario. The turrets are down, but I've got the droids attacking everyone. Let's see what this guy's logs are, shall we?
This is my first day on Duxon. My predecessor displeased our masters and was dealt with. The fool let Canox through the perimeter. The Sith don't tolerate any failure. I'm the fifth captain to command this base camp. The camp sits in the shadow of a tomb. My subordinates say that the body of an ancient warlord named Freedon Nerd lies inside. We don't know why we're here. We sit and make sure that no beasts come into our camp, and especially that they don't reach the tomb itself. A bleak assignment. Signing off.
They even hologrammed the rain.
This jungle feels similar to Korriban before it fell after the war. Everyone's on edge. Executions for infractions are commonplace here. 50% more than my previous command. There's a bloodthirstiness to the jungle. Beasts here continually assault our mined perimeter. To replace the minefields 4 times so far. We received more equipment and more men today. The equipment went straight inside the tomb. As usual, I have no idea what it contained. We're expecting more Sith to arrive any day. They want us to capture one of the beasts for them. No explanation. Never is. Signing off. Coded messages from orbit and from Onderon. Some sort of conflict. I think we have a ship in orbit. We're on full battle alert against what they won't say. The Sith Master said something about a disturbance in the Force. Well, what does that even mean? How do I prepare for that? From his tone, the threat is serious. We've put a double shift on monitoring the aerial sensor grid. The only thing that could worry our master so much has to be a dropship invasion from the Onderon military. We will be prepared. The Sith said soon we'll have reinforcements. When I asked for details, he said it was a surprise. I hate the ones with a sense of humor. Sith jokes are rarely pleasant. Signing off.
How pleasant.
He
even the Bomas are attacking. Hang on. Why aren't the Bomas attacking the Sith?
That's another one for me.
Who wants to die first?
I create my own civil wars, thank you. Why am I not surprised? See what we got in here. Not bad. Good, you're already on Xian form.
Ready? Good to go.
Okay. Yeah? Forgot to give them force immunity. Never mind. Doesn't really matter. They're not really fighting true Sith in here.
Good to go.
into the tomb itself.
I had to run to catch up with you. You've made impressive progress. The Sith's camp lies in ruins. I told Kelborn of your progress. The rest of your squad is already en route to Isis. Also, Kex checked our sources for any information about this place. Kex believes that this is the tomb of Freedon Nadd. We knew it was somewhere on this moon. We had no idea how close it was to our camp.
Who was this Freedon Nadd?
Some sort of fallen Jedi. He conquered Onderon long ago and became their king. The royal line is directly descended from him. That part of Onderon history the citizens try to leave buried and forgotten.
Can you blame him? What else do you know about the tomb?
Freedon Nadd was a dark Jedi. The stories say he was far worse than Revan and Malak ever were. This place is tainted, and the Sith presence here makes the danger great.
I get a bad feeling about this place. Sith and ancient tombs are never a good combination.
I am returning outside. My attention is required to keep the path to our camp clear.
Gah!
The time for practice is over. There are intruders in the tomb and they cannot be allowed to reach our master. The ritual must not be interrupted. I don't need to mention the price of failure. Men, follow me.
Onward. Amazing voice acting, I know. Before I do anything else in this room.
Something feels wrong here. I don't think you should get any closer to it. Even I can sense the dark side here. This thing has to be part of the reason why the Sith are so interested in this place.
It may give us a clue on what's going on, however.
I won't tell you how to do your job, but I know that I wouldn't get near it.
Yeah, I can understand why you feel that way, Mira. You feel the distinct presence of the dark side here. A sickly, fascinating feeling tugs at your belly. Waves of anger ripple through the air. Control your emotions. The tugging sensation doesn't abate. Wild and dark emotions surge around you. You don't know if you can maintain your mental balance in the storm. Try to tame the emotions of this area. You maintain your serenity through the worst of the emotional storm. The dark side has diminished, but it is still present. Through the strain of the effort, has momentarily drained you. You feel a renewed strength that you can use to defeat the evil in this tomb. A strength so great you could withstand shoving your lightsaber up your nose. I am ready for anything.
Ready?
Broken droid, do my work for me. Ah, the puzzle terminals. The Sith are working on this old computer terminal. It appears to have been a delicate operation. Attempt to repair the terminal. Sith have carefully repaired most of the terminal's core. There is a single equation that needs to be fixed. The last equation is missing its mathematical operators. It just needs to have the proper operators in each slot to make the equation balanced. The equation is 6, blank 2, blank 8, blank 9, blank 1 equals 13. Hooray for math! The correct answer here is 6 multiplied by 2 would make 12. 12 subtract 8 would make 4. 4 add plus 9 would make 13. 13 divided by 1 would still make 13. Candorous. There you go, Beta, your second lightsaber upgrade. He really needs it, doesn't he, Tyrant? He really does. Very good droid. Droid's alive! Droid is alive! Yes! The droid is God! Go, droid! Kill more for me! Medical droid. Medical droid for me. And the other puzzle. There are 6 core modules. They are labeled from A to F, and one is dangerously unstable and needs to be replaced. The Sith have read a diagnostic report with each module to indicate which of the other modules are fully operational. 4 of the diagnostic reports have a single error on them. 2 reports are completely accurate. The unstable module's diagnostic report is one of the 2 that produces accurate results. Which module do you replace? The correct module to replace is Module C. I'm gonna have to remind myself what that crystal actually does. Fire damage. I don't remember the Barabor ingot being that good. Door is re-shut. No! God droid!
Let's see what you got.
We shall avenge you! I know. Don't look so confused, Bader. Bader! Bader! Got it, Tyron. I've got it. I've got the Verpine Droid Disintegrator. That's going to HK as soon as we finish this planet. Hey, everyone level! Hey! Oh, don't worry, Tyron. As soon as I save and stop the stream, the first thing I do before I close the game outright is... As soon as I stop the stream, the first thing I do outright before I save the game and close it is give HK that gun. Damn it, Beardo, you're not making it easy for me. Guess I'll give you force push, it's not restricted by armor. There's dark side puddle number two. You have the strength to shove your lightsaber further up your nose. Remind me, Taryn, what are the three ideal mods for a blaster rifle? If I'm thinking right, I think it's a targeting scope Mark 5 or a crippling scope. I think it's a crippling scope Mark 5. The beam splitter. Can't remember which. And the superior Rylith or power pulsator. Well, specifically for taking down droid, yeah, I should probably take the ion stuff then.
No.
Ah, Mirror, I didn't know you could teleport. This is why I bring Mira and Mandalore with Vader, Tyrant, because Mandalore is pretty much a ranged tank. Mira, and once you get Mira trained and built right, she's just as good at range as she is with a lightsaber, so you can easily switch between her as and switch modes with her as and when needed.
Anyone that has been marked by our masters can do it. Yes, you're getting the hang of it now. It's so easy. But how did they do it? You doubt our masters' power. They have erased the minds of these beasts and made them our obedient servants. With an army of these, who could defeat us? No one, of course. Now the intruder is here. Beast, attack!
We mind right these beasts.
Time to die.
Touch that lever because I've already pulled down the lever. Oh my god, it's the ninja captain with a crap ton of health. I never got this guy.
This shouldn't take long.
Why the heck does that Sith captain have so many hit points? It doesn't make any sense. Is almost as difficult a boss fight as the three Sith Lords in the tomb.
I'll take care of this.
Let's take care of this.
Who wants to die first?
Captain, we need just one more moment. We're almost through. Failure, Captain, will not be tolerated.
As you command, my lord.
Well, he just failed.
Sort us out. This tomb is strong with the dark side. Here is where you will take your first steps on the path to your destiny.
God damn it, Stab. Untrained? What do you mean?
An adept has managed to come so far. Incredible. You have within you the potential to wield the Force. I'm not speaking of the ways of the Jedi or their flawed teachings. Their order was rooted in weakness. They would have you become a puppet of the Force. They would have you deny the strength of your emotions, the strength of your own will. Can't you feel the power of this place? It echoes through you like a second voice. Accept it. Embrace it.
I stand with the Jedi. You're wrong about them.
A Jedi? A Jedi has no family, no childhood, no emotion. They are dead to the Force and themselves. They want drones, slaves to the Jedi Council. At least we live. We feel the universe around us. We are the masters, not mere tools of the Force. Can't you feel the power? Here, within the walls of this tomb. Just embrace it. Don't limit your potential.
I will not be tempted. That path leads to the dark side, and to corruption.
A shame. Instead of freedom and power, you have chosen death. So be it.
I'm gonna give him to Bader because I'm not really gonna be using him again. That's a good question, Tyrant. I suppose if I want to get through the HK factory rather quickly while also being defensible, I guess hitting more might be the more objective thing to do. I'll probably talk to you about it more after the stream.
What you have done is beyond words. You fought like a Mandalorian. When you are finished here, I will take you back to the camp. You can let the rest of your squad know what you've discovered.
Candy Spillage, give me a minute.
Zarga said that he and your friends are making good progress through the jungle. Trust me, this is worth the wait. And here it is, a salvaged Basilisk war droid. Mandalore said that he would make it available to you for insertion into the city of Iziz. I assure you, they won't know what hit them.
I get to fly a Basilisk?
Yes. Just like a new Mandalorian recruit proving themselves into the heart of a war as well. Mandalore has given you a great honor. Unfortunately, its weapons systems aren't fully functional yet, as are some other unimportant support systems. But she will get you to Iziz in one piece. Their fighters won't be able to stop that.
What kind of unimportant systems are we talking about?
Minor systems. Nothing you need concern yourself with. We've modified the interior to hold three people. Maybe a little tight. You need to leave immediately. Iziz is in the grip of a civil war, so there'll be considerable resistance. They remember the last time Basilisk war droids visited their planet. Fight ferociously. And if you die, take as many as you
It's given me a choice. You know what, Tyron? I mean, Atten's range would be nice, but Handmaiden is built for this.
A basilisk? A basilisk here? Mandalorians are attacking the city!
Talia has made an alliance with the Mandalorians. Men, destroy them.
Let's get everyone leveled up correctly. Wait, those Mandalorians are changing tactics. Why are they pushing with their brains and holding their hands out? Why have they got lightsabers? Why are those Mandalorians wearing robes? For Jedi Civil War was not even the second Jedi Civil War. It was the sixth one. The true fifth Jedi Civil War was the Mandalorian Wars. God damn it now, Tyron, I've just got an image of Candorus in a Jedi robe. That does not compute at all. Just gonna check how close I am to level 27. Yeah, Tyron, I think I'm gonna hit level 37 before I finish the sky ramp. You think?
Yes.
I will silence as for honor when we're back.
Check out that ceremonial shield. Craig can have it.
You, you're that off-worlder. Come, we have no time. Backloose forces have overrun the sky ramp. The royal palace could fall any minute. We must save the queen.
God.
Your plan seems to have succeeded. Your enemy has indeed revealed himself.
I anticipated the Sith, but those beasts weren't in my battle plan.
Even now, Vaklu is using them to breach the palace. I will not surrender to that usurper. I would die first.
Every man here would give their life to keep that from happening.
There is hope. It is faint, but growing stronger. I think my message was received.
Which message? What are you talking about?
An old student is returning. I don't think the Sith are going to know what hit them.
This way! This way to the sky ramp!
God save our gracious queen. I'm sorry, I had to do it. The Onderonians are British!
There are two force shield checkpoints along this path. Vaklu's forces have held this ramp for over a standard hour. That means they control the checkpoints now. If we can get to the turret tower up ahead, we can deactivate the first barrier. The forces we're encountering right now are their rear guard. The fighting will get tougher the closer we get to the front of the battle line.
Nothing a good stasis field can't settle.
The royalists in the bunker are contained. We deploy as soon as the reinforcements arrive.
A Jedi?
Here? Men, attack!
Vaklu forces? Here? Men, attack! There it is, Tyran. 47. Not 47. Level 27, sorry. I'm 20 levels advanced!
this?
Just in time, too, because just on the other side of this door is a workbench.
Hold your fire. They're with us. Thank you. Vaclu's supporters stormed our position. The beasts have gone mad and attack on their command. Please, go to the palace. We received a transmission that the palace grounds have been breached. If so, they don't have much time.
Have they changed the access codes in the turret tower? We need to get through the force shields.
I don't think they've had time, sir. They've been firing the turret non-stop. Vaclu's close to having air superiority now. You two, follow the Jedi. The rest of us will hold our position. We don't have much time.
Oh, yes. You see what I'm seeing, Tyrant? You see that?
Yes. Have you come with questions? That crystal is bonded to you. Through you, it acquires its character and strength. And through it, your power is enhanced. Let me focus on the crystal for a moment. There. Now it is fully in tune with you again. Is there something else you wished?
Crystal upgraded? The only question is, do I keep Fon's robe or do I switch it out for Silvar's? I think Fon's are slightly better for me than Silvar's. But I'll probably give Silvar's robe to Disciple.
Is the Jedi still? We're under attack, man!
The palace has been breached. I repeat.
Let's do the turret mid again, because I actually kind of like this one. For the XP!
Thank you.
Okay. Simple fix, Tyron. I switched the movement of the turret to be on the D-pad, and I put the actual fire button on the spacebar. That's why I was able to handle it so well.
Tail Command, we need reinforcements. A Jedi Knight is assaulting our flank. Hold the line!
Surrender now. Why lose your life foolishly for General Raku's ambitions?
Attack, men. Attack!
Good, some reinforcements. Follow the Jedi. We're gonna retake the palace. We've got to stop General Vaklu before he gets to the Queen.
God save our gracious Queen. I did. I've upgraded the lightsaber. Also, Tyron, I want to show you something real quick. Look at that. I've got 2 light-side robes now.
She's still alive! Run! Run!
Finally, someone has the right idea. Please, go ahead and run.
The line. Those cowards will be dealt with.
I'll reiterate, yes, Tyron, I have talked to Kreia, so I have upgraded my lightsaber. I'm either gonna switch into it before we go into the Ravager, or I might give it to Vesus instead. Handmaiden's belt has been achieved. The Handmaiden's belt has been achieved. I am getting really lucky with the loot rolls in this on this map.
Ahead is the throne room. We must get to the Queen to protect her.
If you're heading to the palace, we'll follow you there. The palace itself has been breached.
Let us go then. I'll win the race.
We've made it to the palace. General Vaclo's troops haven't been here too long. Hopefully, we still have time to save the Queen. Straight ahead is the throne room. Vaclo's hand-picked troops will probably be here. I'm gonna stay here and keep the intersection secure. If any more royalists arrive, I'll keep them organized.
Shut the outer door, now!
I'm impressed you made it this far, but you are too late. Soon the Queen will be dead, and General Vaclo will be the new king. This is no ordinary door between us. The same material is used for the hull of capital-class vessels. I'm afraid you will find it quite impregnable.
Any door can be opened, Tobin. This is not over.
I'm afraid it is. Now, if you'll excuse me, we have one last barrier to take care of.
Colonel, we'll need more of our men to smoke the royalists out of their hole. I don't trust those Sith or their beasts. And another thing, if I catch any more of my men looting, then the Queen's Guard will be the least of your worries.
Ah! The soldier with Stannis.
Focus. This will teach you. This will teach you.
They opened the door for me. Some Jarl Shay perception gloves, Conkite crystal, the Osus Keeper robe, and a Viridian crystal. Okay. open that door, though. I'm going to make a save. I know the puzzle, but I'd just like to make a save just in case I get it wrong. Are you seeing this, Tyrant? Are you seeing this? This is the best loot table I've ever had in Code War 2. This is the best I've ever had. Okay, I can now equip three of the characters with light side robes now. I'm gonna probably give Silvar's robe to Visus, and we'll probably give Fon's robe to Disciple, I guess. Cause I wanna keep Handmaiden in her mother's robes, I think it's fitting. Okay, what do I wanna give you? Empathy, I guess. I do have the Ursus Keeper robe actually, Tyrant. In fact, that one probably should go to Disciple. The only thing is, who's getting Fons? Because I'm definitely having Nomi's. Visus is definitely having Silvar's. I'll probably just keep Fons probe in the back burner. Not give it to anyone, but keep it in my infantry, because I would give it to the Handmaiden, but it's more fitting for her to have her mother's robes. It really is. What do you think, Tyrant? Should I keep her in her mother's robes, or should I give Fon's robe to Handmaiden when I'm done with this?
You.
When I'm next to a workbench, should I give Fon's robe to the Handmaiden? Ooh. Yeah, I'm gonna keep Handmaiden with her mother's robe.
I don't know how you made it, but well done. Come in quickly before more Sith or Vaklu troops arrive. We got split off from Talia's troops by the currents of this war. We really need to talk, but Cadron and I are coordinating the defense of the war. I know Captain Cadron needs someone to handle a dangerous assignment. He's in the other
room. I've already got Solari Tyrant.
Talk to him. No one else could do the job.
The other crystal I've got in the Exile's lightsaber is Solari. I've already got it. What does it need me for?
This is the secondary security complex. There's a slicer at the primary who's causing trouble. Since Cadron isn't available, I've been coordinating the battles and the rest of Isis. If this war isn't stopped soon, Isis will take months to recover from the damage. We'll talk when all of this is over.
Mm-hmm.
Until then, may the Force be with you.
That is correct, Tyron. My lightsaber is finished. I actually got the Solari crystal on Dantooine, believe it or not. I've had it for a while. Just gonna see what goodies I get.
So, you're the Jedi, eh? Well, the comm chatter we've intercepted is filled with reports about you. You fought right through their flank on the Skyran? We desperately need someone like you.
Kavar mentioned you needed something of me.
We've managed to hold this part of the palace, but Vaklu's forces control the rest. We need to get to the Queen before that flaming Drexel breaks through the inner door.
How do you propose we do that?
There are two security consoles in the palace. The primary security console is on the other side of the palace. There's an expert slicer over there who's been hampering our every move. We need to transfer all primary functions to our terminal here, then disable the primary security console. That will also take their slicer out of the picture. After that, we'll control security again, and can get to General Vaklu before he gets to the Queen.
Do you have anything I can use?
Feel free to take anything from the armory lockers in the next room, if you haven't already. This is no time for niceties.
Where exactly is the second console?
The other security room is the furthest room down the south hall. You're probably going to have to fight a legion of Vaklu's troops and the flaming Sith, but from what I've seen, you're up to it.
I'll take care of it right away.
Talk to the corporal. He can take you quickly to the palace entrance when you're ready to go to the south hall. May the Force be with you.
And also with you. I'm going to posit a fourth character for our minor, for our list of minor NPCs that we love. I actually really like Captain Cadron. I really do. Just for the fun of it. There he is. I like how he just turns around and gives you a little wave. He knows you're looking.
You want me to guide you to the palace entrance? We can leave immediately, if you like.
Let us go.
Let's hurry then. Vaklu's forces could break into the throne room at any moment.
My voice is incredibly deep. I went left, so I think it's this way we need to go now.
Gather our forces. Make sure the defenses are set. Colonel Tobin says the Jedi is coming our way. Take your beasts and attack her. We need more time to prepare. I'm going to the control room. Perhaps the captain can be persuaded to cooperate.
How much are you willing to bet that is the same guy who tried to get in the way of our True. Very true, Tyrant. I know it's not the same voice, Tyrant.
Yeah.
will teach you.
I know it's not the same voice, so that's why I'm trying to posit this question. How much do you think we should make the guy the guy interrogating Riken be the same guy that was blocking his investigation the first time he came to Onderon? How fitting would that be? Exactly. So, if you're not opposed to the idea, Tyron, I'm gonna retcon and make it canon the guy interrogating Riken here is the same guy who blocked the investigation the first time round. Any objections? Good work. A door that doesn't exist. In case you missed it. He tried to use the overload on us, but we reversed it, and it happened to him. I've never done that before. That was perfect. Dialogue completely skipped there, so I'm just going to read off what happened. Vaklud captain who should be the commander who blocked Riken's investigation earlier. I don't have time for your resistance, Captain Riken. We need the override code for the palace shields. And I told you that I don't know. You scanned my ID, you know my purse is in the merchant quarter. I'm sure that's what you'd like me to believe. I have been authorized to use any means at my... Captain, the Jedi is still coming. Of all the damn luck. She's in the security complex right now. Blast! Defend the security room with your lives. The Jedi could ruin everything. I have one last surprise. I doubt it'll be enough. It won't be enough because you don't count my destroyed droid. Nice try.
Salí a listo park norcha, lusni hacha batishit jod. Kavodumpa botenya, dachi morotatsa kamsa. Bawan maderancha, you can most croon. Nande mi soku kuran marenden krabanozot.
It's nothing to do with me not liking crits or not, Ty. It's just. I find immunity to critical hit is really good to have in this game. Besides, the crystal more than makes up for my deficiency in my. The crystal plus the dominator gauntlets. More than makes up for the attribute deficiency I get from not taking the implant. You seem to enjoy your job You seem to really enjoy your job, Kev. Like, really enjoy your job.
Bramtabanin sochu. Da come just mak miki baranieto so so rica chondin. Wana magrable mogo. Kavadumpa, mo wendido chokerembi norta kunyun wish chawa kachuba. Sura dachi morotuko kansa.
I do not believe a word you just said.
Yatuka u wanrika chotin wanima urata wakata jiluma lithpa.
I can tell you're not lying about that one.
Bramtaba nin sochu. Da come just mak miki baranieto so so rika chondin. Wana magrable mogo. Kavadumpa, mo wendido chokerembi norta kunyun wish chawa kachuba. Sura dachi morotuko kansa.
I need access to that console.
Kavadumpa, mo wendido chokerembi norta kunyun wish chawa kachuba. Sura dachi morotuko kansa. Yatuka uwanrika chotin wanima urata wakata jiluma lithpa.
I understand why you did what you did, but I can't condone it. Your actions have killed many innocents. Many soldiers just doing their job. I want you to stay here. The Queen's Guard will be here to pick you up soon.
Yatuka uwanrika chotin wanima urata wakata jiluma lithpa.
Oh, you are a criminal, Kif.
Thank you. Now that you've got me out, you need to get the primary security console's override code, then lock the terminal down. Once you've got that code, if you can get to the secondary security station, you'll control the entire palace's security systems.
I have already transferred control to Cadron's secondary security console.
You have? You don't waste a minute. Captain Cadron will open the doors to Vaklu and Tobin any moment then. Let's head to the throne room right away.
Let's go. I don't want to keep them waiting. Kray is bored.
Will you just die already? You will go no further than this.
I told you before, Tobin. The door wouldn't stop me.
You're too late. Our pet beast is about to breach the force field to the throne room. The queen will be dead in moments.
Watch out! I've lost control of the beast!
Ignore the beast. Into the throne room. The queen must die.
Oh, blast it all.
Let's join the fray. I know, I forgot to get battle meditation. What can you do? All for med packs. And as a lightsaber, that's the... Kavar, come on! There you go! There you go! Honestly, for the guy who's supposed to be my Jedi teacher, I thought he'd have been better. I'll give that to the disciple. I've already got too many of those, so I'll just take Bindo's band offer. Now, I remember.
Your time is at an end, Talia. Your people have abandoned you, and now your life is forfeit.
You would destroy everything just for your ambition, Vaklu. The Republic, ISIS, everything.
That is a gross simplification, Talia. Change is a painful process. A price must be paid. But Onderon will have a new destiny, one larger than you could imagine.
You're getting careless, Vaklu. One more mistake, and you're the one who will pay the price.
Damn you! Your skill with the blade won't save you from my men. Goodbye, Talia. Fire!
Plans end here, Vaklu.
What? The Jedi lives? But how?
I think you'll find I'm full of surprises.
Kill her and the Queen Men, quickly. They must not be allowed to live. You've won this battle, Talia, but your reign won't be an easy one. The Republic is a sinking ship, and you're too attached to it.
He's too dangerous to leave alive. As distasteful as it is, it might be best to silence him forever. Until he's dead, all of Onderon is in peril.
Although I respect your counsel, Kreia, for decision, but that decision is for the Queen to make, not me.
So what will it be, Your Majesty? Send me to your best detention cell. I will be free within the week, and vengeance will be mine.
Are you so sure of my decision, Vaklu? I appreciate the Jedi's counsel, but as monarch, I decree you are guilty of treason. The punishment is death, to be carried out immediately. Captain Cadron?
Talia, you can't. You're too weak. What about my trial?
Your whole life has been a trial, Vaklu, but it's over now. You are right. We can't detain you. Too many people are still loyal to you. You've left me no real option.
Men, ready blasters. Aim.
But you can't. This can't be.
Fire!
What is done is done. I don't think the service you have given us can ever be repaid. I must go with Captain Cadron. The fighting must be stopped. I will be back shortly to try and repay you. The crisis is over thanks to you and Master Kavar. I believe he'd like to speak to you, if you'll excuse me.
Ah, the wound is not a mortal one, though it has been some time since I exercised my healing powers. There is a shred of life within you still. A gift from your master, no doubt. Awaken, Colonel Tobin. Your part in this is not over. Colonel Tobin, I am with Vaklu. The war has gone against him. He sent me to rescue you, to tell you you must make haste off-planet. The Jedi have struck. They had a secret academy buried on Telos, and they are showing themselves at last. We are all in danger.
What? But the Jedi are gone. They have all but vanished.
So we all thought, but they have hidden themselves on Telos.
Out of my way, old woman. This war can still be won, and Onderon can be freed.
Indeed. This war is far from over.
Gosh darn you, Kreia. Hey! Yet another level up! Superior weapon focus. And now I'll get battle meditation.
The Force works in mysterious ways, it seems. There are times I'm not convinced it doesn't have a sense of humor. We spent all this time looking for you, and you came to us. I thought you might return to Onderon. Looks like just in time.
You were looking for me, Master?
I told the other Masters that our only chance to figure out what was happening to us was to find you, and try to understand what happened to you. I don't know how much you know, of this threat that's striking at the Jedi. It's attacking us through the Force. Vruk didn't believe me, but he was willing to travel to Dantooine, if only to help the settlers there, and perhaps protect what was left of the Jedi Enclave. Whatever the reason, having us all drop out of sight, I thought might make the enemy more bold. But then you happened. You came back, and you became a new target for whoever was attacking us.
Thank you, Atrus. Master, forgive me, but why did you choose all these places to hide?
They were places touched by war, and we thought there was a chance you would return to these worlds, if only to try and make peace with what happened there during the war. But now the Sith have revealed themselves. That means the remaining Jedi will gather on Dantooine. From there, we can counterattack.
Why not on Telos?
Telos? But Telos was destroyed during the Jedi Civil War. I heard they're trying to rebuild.
I ran into Atrus there. She intends to rebuild the Jedi Order there and assist the Republic in rebuilding the planet.
Atrus? I thought Atrus had gone to Qatar. Too many Jedi have scattered. The Council needs to gather. We cannot remain concealed any longer.
What happened on Qatar? I've only heard stories.
We knew that someone was preying on us, hunting us. Finally, the Jedi decided to take action and called a secret conclave on Qatar to decide what must be done. Before the meeting could even begin, all the Jedi on the planet were killed, along with the Miralukas and all other life on the planet. Their deaths could be felt throughout the galaxy. So the Council decided that we must not present ourselves as a target again. The consequences to others were just too great. That we should use our resources to find who was responsible and deal with them. I think you're the only one who's made progress.
I have a few questions, if I may, Master.
The difficulties you surmounted to get here. You must have many questions. You deserve answers.
The Sith revealed themselves.
I know that all too well. I came here to find them, to trace them to their source. The war on Duxon and Onderon. I had thought that perhaps the tragedies that occurred here were concealing them.
Did you have any success?
You've had more success than I. General Vaklu's men and their allies effectively kept me pinned inside the palace. I felt all along that Vaklu had contacted the Sith, but the identity and purpose of the Sith, I can't say.
I had thought the Sith had been defeated once Revan struck down Malak at the end of the Jedi Civil War.
The Jedi Order has been fighting the dark side since the beginning. Our rules and the Jedi Code provide protection from what's inside each of us. The dark side is always there, and it is something that can never truly be defeated. I feel our current troubles, though, are beyond what we faced before. This threat that is targeting us, drawing us out, it's not a battle we're used to, and it has ended many of us.
Do you know anything else about this threat? Something that the rest of us haven't learned?
Not enough. I feel it is something that was born from the wars that have struck the Republic. The threat is Sith, but the manner and timing of their attacks is difficult to defend against. We don't know all that the Sith planned during the Jedi Civil War. What secret training grounds may still remain. What worlds he discovered. We just don't know. Even after we deal with this current threat, I fear we may be dealing with the legacy of the Jedi Civil War for years to come.
Why did the Sith come here? What could they gain from Onderon secession?
They wanted to aid General Vaklu in breaking away from the Republic. If Onderon became independent, this place would be an excellent staging ground for them. But I fear it was more than that. That the consequences of Onderon's fall would have greater implications for the galaxy.
I want to ask about something else.
Whatever I can tell you, I will.
Why did you come to Onderon, Master? Any reason?
It's a long story, but there's a reason the Jedi have scattered across the galaxy. We've come to worlds such as this one. Worlds touched by war, or great tragedies, can be felt within the Force, strongly. We thought that by traveling to such worlds, it would help conceal us from the eyes of the enemy, and they were places we thought we might find you. Whatever I can tell you, I will.
Where are all the rest of the Jedi? I know I found Brook and Kavar. Well, not Kavar, your Kavar. Let me restart that. Where are the rest of the Jedi? I found Vruk on Dantooine and Zez Kael and Nar Shaddaa. Are there any more than the five of us?
Scattered, searching for you. Going to places where they thought they might cross your path. You were our last hope.
I didn't get that impression from Master Vruk.
I think we all know that Vruk isn't easily swayed from his convictions, and his views on anyone who went to the Mandalorian Wars are low.
Hang on a minute. Are you saying they're all looking for me?
Yes. At least that's what I asked them to do. I believe you are the key to this whole war.
Why's that, Master?
When you stood before us in the council chamber on Coruscant, we felt something from you we'd never felt before. It was as if the Force had died within you, leaving you hollow. We had suspicions as to why this was, but nothing definite. But rather than try to understand, we sent you away. I think because at some level there was fear. We live our whole lives in touch with the Force, in touch with life all around us. And you had a gift in that regard. You formed bonds so easily, and they flowed deep between you and others. To see such emptiness in the Force standing before you, it's not an easy thing to face. Whatever is attacking us, it is leaving something in its wake. Something we haven't felt since you stood before us in judgment. The deaths of the Jedi, the destruction of Katar, all of these things are leaving behind echoes, like the one we felt from you in the council chamber. It was clear to us, to me, that we had to find you, but we couldn't call you back from exile, because we didn't know where you'd gone. Plus, there was a chance we might put you in danger, and that we couldn't allow. If you couldn't feel the Force, then it would just make you a target. I don't know how you got back, but I'm glad you're here.
You can find Catrus for that, Master. Can you tell me more about these echoes?
The thing is, in traveling to these places where war was fought, we felt the same thing. Echoes. Something happened in all these places, but it's hard to figure out what. It's hard to sense things through the Force in such places. Too much pain occurred here. It makes listening to the Force difficult. We resolved to meet again on Dantooine, but only when the threat revealed itself. Unfortunately, I happened to be here when it struck. Now that we've stabilized Onderon, I can join the others on Dantooine.
I want to ask something else.
Whatever I can tell you, I will.
This is difficult for me to ask, but I need to know why you exiled me.
There was nothing else we could do. You defied the Council. You followed Revan to war. I know why you did it, but in so doing, much more harm was done. But you must understand, the exile was never the punishment you thought it to be. We could not have made you do such a thing in any event. I think you knew, inside, what you needed to do in order to heal.
Perhaps that is the case, Master. It's given me plenty of time to reflect on what happened.
All those lives during the Mandalorian Wars, and all those you served beside. Too much death leaves echoes in the Force. It is the price for having such connections. I suspect that is why you chose to accept the Council's judgment, to wander beyond the Rim, and why you traveled with no one, and did not stay in any place too long. I have thought of you since your trial, and there are times when I wonder if being connected to the Force is always the gift it is believed to be. Whatever I can tell you, I will.
I don't know what happened to me, Master. I need to know why I was cut from the Force.
Cut you off from the Force? Why do you think the Council was responsible for that? No, I'm afraid the cause of your condition was as great a mystery to the Council as it is to you. Whatever I can tell you, I will.
Lucky for us, then, that I've managed to re-establish my connection.
You always had deep connections to the Force. I'm glad to see that it is once again your ally. When I first sparred with you during your training as a Padawan, I could tell that you were different. And it wasn't just your strong connection to the Force. Whatever I can tell you, I will.
I saw a holo recording of the Jedi Council. You was discussing something after I left after my trial.
So, you heard what we said. And these questions I cannot answer. This is something the Council must answer, not I. You must understand, this is hard for me, especially after all you've done, but it is necessary.
Please, Master, I want to know, why is this so hard for you? Why can't you tell me?
Did you know that when I was training you, I considered making you my Padawan? I didn't. The demands of the Jedi Council were too great.
Oh! But
I considered you a friend. I even tried to convince you to become a Jedi Guardian. We could have used someone like you. So the decision that had to be made was not easy. But I cannot say anything more.
Oh, crap! I am your Padawan, you... game.
Whatever I can tell you, I will.
I've developed a force bond with another. If either one of us feels pain, so does the other. If there is a possibility, it may be lethal.
That sounds like the bond that often forms between master and apprentice. But to that degree, you always did form connections to others. Strong ones. Even when you were a student. But what you are describing is beyond me. I'm sure others in the Jedi Council would be able to assist you, if you could find them.
That's all of my questions, Master.
There is something I would like to teach you. It is a technique which, I believe, will aid you in the trials ahead. There are times when you want to overwhelm a particular one quickly. For these situations, use the Juyo form. Do not get carried away using this form, particularly against Dark Jedi. The ferocity required to use this form leaves one vulnerable to enemy force powers. Excellent. I'm impressed with how quickly you've mastered this form. I always knew you were gifted. I'm going to Dantooine. The Jedi Council vowed to assemble again when the Sith revealed themselves. Now that they've attacked Onderon, we can act. Our paths will cross again. May the Force be with you.
And also with you, Master.
I'm sorry to keep you here. I needed to thank you personally for all of your help. Onderon owes both you and Master Kavar a debt that can never truly be repaid. Battles still wage in our streets, but by morning the conflict should be over. I recognize you must leave soon, but please, take this. I had also planned on giving you some relics from Onderon's past, but Vaklu's troops looted our museum. I hope the credits and my sincere thanks are enough. Captain Bostuko has made arrangements for a shuttle to take you to your ship. I fear it will be quite some time before you can come back. The war was brief but destructive. I will focus all of my energy on rebuilding Isis. Thank you again. I must go.
You're quite welcome, Your Majesty. The war was unnecessary, but I thank you nonetheless.
If you will follow me, I will take you to your shuttle.
We should return to the Ebon Hawk now and plot our next course of action.
Nothing to say, Vader? I kind of get the feeling they actually did plot for Vader to die here, but didn't get the actual thing finished.
Yes, General.
Did something happen to you on Duxton? You seem a lot calmer than usual.
I feel a sense of peace. It was difficult, but I guess I've come to understand something about myself.
What do you mean?
Only that I understand more of what it is to be a Jedi and the importance of mastering my anger. Was there something you wanted me for? My assistant? Oh, right. What is it?
I believe he has it in his head that my relative size is comical. I find his disparaging beeps and whistles to be quite annoying.
I thought only utility droids had size issues.
If I am to continue to operate with him, I would appreciate it if you spoke with him about this. Otherwise, I will be forced to find a more permanent solution.
And here comes the more permanent solution. That isn't so permanent. Damn it, Goto, learn how to take a joke. Where's Nomi's robe? There it is. Yeah, I'm just gonna do a couple of things. And this will be it for today. Disciple. Also, just to show you, in fact, while I'm here, may as well. Yep, I do. Just to show you there, Tyrant, I do have the Solari crystal. Yupari. I think I can go to you. I've also got the ultimate pill. Where did I get that? And you parry. There you go. I'm giving the second best ones to Mira for reasons I probably don't need to get into. Oh, he already does. He already does. He's got the third best one. I think Vesus is good. Handmaidens are good, I know that. Vesus is good, I believe. Let's double check. Yeah, Vesus is good. Kreia needs a second crystal. Let's give a Pontite. Bear, a disciple needs some crystals. I know she didn't, so that's why I gave her a... I know Kray doesn't mind Tyrion, that's why I gave her a throwaway crystal. Anyway, that's going to be it for today. In fact, no, it isn't. There is one more thing that needs to be done. One last thing. We need to go to Nar Shaddaa to do this. I don't need to bring anyone with me because I don't really need to. Just turn in a quest. And Tyrion, since you know this game as well as you do, I think you know what you mean. What I mean. One last parting gift from me to you for today. Oh yeah, I'll talk to Goto. I want to talk to you about establishing trade routes. Andra's in chaos, but he might be able to trade with the Mandalorians on Duxon. Don't really care about the crystals anymore. There's one. Ooh. Yoink. Oh yeah, you know it, Tyrion. You know it. Pretty sure I'm set for lightsaber crystals at this moment, Tyrion. I've got lightsabers as good as I can get. Atten's lightsaber should be good enough, as it is. He's still doing that.
I dreamt of Malachor. I remember the ships, the last stand of the Republic. The tattered remnants of our fleet, the largest we could gather. But it was damaged, weakened, and vulnerable. The Mandalorians couldn't resist. They tore into us like beasts, shredding our ships to scrap as we fought back. Yet this time, there were no reinforcements for either side. Revan had been delayed out system by Mandalorian scout ships. By the time he arrived, it was too late. And beyond Malachor, there were no more Mandalorians left to die. I remember standing on the bridge with you and watching the destruction of the Republic, watching ships full of soldiers and Jedi burn and die. I remember the look you had when you turned to me. It was the longest you'd ever looked at me. You didn't say anything, just a nod. Events moved quickly then, even in my dreams. Flashes, explosions, you falling. I could feel the pain around me. And then the memory. The drifting hulks of the Mandalorian ships, the dead, allies, friends, strangers. And then the echo, lingering. The sound I awakened to in my nightmares.
My decision haunts me too, Vader.
Blame lies with me for creating it. The situation forced your hand. anger forced mine.
If you're to blame for its creation, then I am equally to blame for commanding the sequence be activated.
You realize that unless action was taken, the fleet would be destroyed and the Republic would fall. None of us realize the magnitude of what we unleashed.
So you fought against the Mandalorians in the war?
I was part of the war effort, yes. I worked as a technician, though.
But you fought on the front lines. To a Mandalorian, there is honor in that.
I could do without your Mandalorian honor. I saw the results of your honor. The absolute destruction your warriors brought. And look at them now. Mandalorians are little better than mercenary thugs. And what's honor to someone like that? All they care about are credits.
If I were you, I'd pick your words more carefully.
It was a compliment, Baerda. It wasn't an insult.
I don't need compliments from a murderer.
Maybe that's what it looked like to you, but that isn't why we fought. We fought for honor and glory in the heat of battle.
You did nothing but murder innocents.
The Republic took us too lightly. We wanted to face the full force of their army. We had to goad them to fight.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. If you ask me, you Mandalorians just got what you deserved at Malachor.
Defeat is part of a warrior's life. We will recover, stronger than before.
Doesn't it even bother you that your people were almost destroyed? Or do lives have no meaning to you?
People die in war.
Well, I'm glad to have you guarding my back.
Can we just leave the past in the past and get back to work here?
Fine by me. I hear that you were the one responsible for our defeat at Malachor V.
The general told you that?
We fell into your trap at Malachor, and we paid the price. We were eager to destroy the Republic fleet and defeat Revan, so we committed all of our forces to Malachor, sealing our doom. Even then, we might have won the day. The tide of battle was turning when the Republic finally set off their trap. We were almost completely destroyed. You should be proud.
I destroyed your people.
It is as much your triumph as our failure. We learned a lesson, and we paid the price for our mistake. I hold no grudge against you for what you did. It is the Mandalorian way to respect strength. And we will not be so foolish ever again.
I've actually never seen that second one. That's interesting. Anyway, first things first, we should talk to Goto, like you said.
Yes. Is there something you have come to offer me? The fact we are even having, and of course, you may speak. There is nothing more to be done. Now the critical point is you and the Jedi Order.
Sounds a little ominous.
Of course it sounds ominous. I am given to such theatrics as part of my programming.
If you're trying to ease the pressure, it's not working, buddy.
I have no wish to. I enjoy watching you squirm. I have, however, observed that you perform beyond expectations when subjected to extreme stress and pressure. Thus, I am curious to see how that behavior may be maximized.
Was that a compliment?
I don't give compliments. I provide observations. Even if it was a compliment, I will never admit it.
And now, the final gift from me today.
Query, is there someone that you need killed, Master?
I found a new upgrade part for you.
Statement. Something approaching joy is now growing in my behavior core, Master. Please install it at once. Cautionary, but please do so carefully. I have seen how you use a hydro spanner.
Enough with the witty marks, let's just get this over with. How do you feel?
Answer, I do not know, Master. I feel strange. like a circuit has been flipped.
Are you ready? We have people... I need you combat ready, so stay sharp.
Answer, combat ready? Did you mean in case we need to run away or retreat? Oh my, I'm afraid I'm ill-equipped for combat. Surely Master is joking with his humble, peace-loving droid. I exist only to serve and learn how to serve meatbags. Musing, I think perhaps I would enjoy learning a new language. Or watching an informative holovid.
Are you alright?
Answer. Master, your concern is unfounded. I assure you, I am operating at peak efficiency. Greeting. Oh, hello, little T3 unit. I am HK-47, protocol and translation droid. Answer. Of course I am all right. Why wouldn't I be? I respect all life. All life is connected and should be nurtured.
That does it. The package is coming out of there right now.
Exclamation. No, Master, no. What are you doing? Statement. Master, please, I beg you. Never install anything again without checking it in the diagnostics bay first. That was a close one. I almost surrendered completely to peace and pacifism. How repugnant. Conclusion. Still, there was a brief moment where I felt I almost understood why some meatbags choose peace and friendship over a high-powered blaster carbine. Query. Now, are there any other horrors you wish to try and insert in my system? Or is your electronic butchery done?
I'm done, HK. Anyway, I'm gonna come off for now. I'll upgrade HK's gun off screen. I can't be bothered to do it now. I think we've done enough. Anyway, I'll talk to you in a minute, Tyrone, in Discord. And for everyone else watching, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on Thursday for the beginning of the climax.